A lot of families ask us, am I going to have a C-section because my baby's going to be so ill? And I think that overall vaginal delivery is preferable.
Most infants with CDH will undergo a fairly routine labor. They'll be monitored typically, and most of them undergo a vaginal delivery.
We were surprised because we thought that it would be better for them just to get her out real fast and be able to do what they needed to do with her. But they actually told us that it would be better for her to be delivered naturally. So we did that, and she was born naturally.
Many times what we will do is schedule an induction of labor as long as the cervix is favorable, such that everybody has a heads up and is ready and waiting for the baby when it's born.
It's a big deal to coordinate everything. So it's important that the obstetricians and the surgeons and the neonatologists and the ECMO team and the nursing staff, you know when that baby's coming, because we all want to be there and we want to be ready.
The fetus and the newborn with a severe diaphragmatic hernia problem is as fragile as any baby we take care of at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia.
And one of the things that's important is to monitor labor progress and the status of the fetus in utero just prior to labor, and be able to hand the neonatologist a baby who is in an optimal condition for resuscitation.
The issue is to minimize incremental risk factors that could lead to the baby dying. And one such resource, which is amazing, is the special delivery unit, where all of the baby's care, all of the mother's care, can occur in one place.
The special delivery unit, or SDU, is a unit that was designed especially for a baby born with an anomaly who's going to need an intervention shortly after birth.
All of the baby's care, all of the mother's care, can occur in one place with state-of-the-art resources before birth, during birth, and after birth.
So the baby with congenital diaphragmatic hernia who needs expert multidisciplinary care from the first moment is the perfect example of the type of pregnancy that we feel should be delivered in the SDU.
We weren't expecting her to cry, so she cried out and she opened her eyes and looked at us.
They let us say hello and whisked her into the next room to start taking care of her.
The baby requires prompt intubation with an endotracheal tube, requires placement of a nasogastric tube, which decompresses what is often a dilated stomach.
Remember, the stomach is in the chest, so if the baby gulps air, the stomach expands, takes up even more space in the chest.
Requires placement of intravenous lines, monitoring lines, usually an umbilical arterial line for arterial blood pressure monitoring and for blood gases. All that needs to be done quickly and expertly.
And then once the baby is stabilized, they transport the baby over to the neonatal intensive care unit, where additional personnel from the team are ready and waiting for the baby to further evaluate the baby and decide what the best medical management is.